Okay, so last class we have seen how the materials are classified, that is into three types based on the number of electrons. It is classified into conductors, insulators and semiconductors. Okay, and we have seen the various types of bands also, that is valence band, conduction band and then energy gap. Okay, so based on the electrons in the particular bands, the mobility also differs. Now we are going to study about the energy band question in a semiconductor at 0 Kelvin, and we have studied the classification of semiconductors also. There are two types of semiconductors, one is elemental semiconductors, another one is compound. But we are not going to deal with the common semiconductors, only we are going to study the elemental semiconductors. For that, germanium and silicon are the examples. Okay, so in the semiconductor at 0 Kelvin, how the energy band looks. So here they given the energy levels of the two bands, one is a valence band, another one is conduction band. Okay, and the valence band and the conduction band both also separated by the energy gap. Here the conduction band is almost empty and it has the lowest energy level, but the conduction band is almost filled with the electrons and it has the highest energy levels. Okay, so at 0 Kelvin, mostly the electrons are immobile or intact only in the valence band itself. Okay, so most of the semiconductors at 0 Kelvin acts like a insulator because there is no mobility of an electron. Okay, here you can see at 0 Kelvin in a valence band energy levels it has the highest energy level, whereas in a conduction band it has the lowest energy level. So the electrons are immobile to move or to gain the energy or to acquire the energy from the external factors, and it's unable to move to the conduction band. Basically, in the metals, we cannot distinguish the energy gap because both also overlap. The valence band as well as the conduction band, both also get overlaps, but here we cannot distinguish that. Okay, so this is at 0 Kelvin. Note that at 0 Kelvin is nothing but -273 Kelvin. Okay, the lowest attainable temperature, that is 0 Kelvin, -273 degrees Celsius, not in a Kelvin, -273 degrees Celsius. So here the electrons are intact with the ground, that is the valence band itself. So in a valence band it has the highest energy level, whereas it is filled with the most of the electrons. But in a conduction band the electrons are mostly empty. Okay, no electrons are there since it has the lowest energy levels. Okay, now we are going to study the materials based on their energy bands. They have three materials, that is metals, semiconductors and insulators. In these three kinds of the materials, how the energy bands are there? First one is in metals, and in a second one semiconductors. And in the third one, insulators. So first we'll see the metals. In the metals, this is a energy band, that is valence energy band. Okay, so we can say it is a valence band. And a small space is provided from the valence band to the conduction band, and this is the energy of the conduction band. Okay, this is the conduction band. Then the space between the valence band and conduction band is called energy gap or the forbidden energy levels. Okay, so in metals, particularly at room temperature, which means we are raising the temperature, so that is the external factor. So when a temperature is raised to the semiconductor from 0 Kelvin, there may be a mobility that we see in the semiconductors. But in the metals at room temperature, so mostly the valence band itself have a two type of energy levels. One is the lower energy level and the higher energy level. So from the lower energy level to higher energy levels, the electrons, that is a charge carriers, that is able to move from the one band to the upper band. So here the resistance is very less and the conductivity is possible. Okay, so mostly the two bands are overlapping. So because of the overlapping, the energy value, energy gap value, that would be approximately equal to zero. So here the conductivity is possible. So this is in metals. So note that in metals, the energy gap value approximately equal to zero electron volt. Whereas in the semiconductors, the valence band and the conduction bands are differentiated. In the semiconductors, the valence band and the conduction bands are differentiated. So this is valence band and this one is conduction band. So both also differentiated. This is valence band and this is conduction band. And here the energy gap is, so in the semiconductors, the energy gap value should be less than 3 electron volt. So at room temperature, in the semiconductors like a germanium and the silicon, germanium or silicon, the energy gap would be less than 3 electron volt. So that only the semiconductors have possess the properties of both metals and the non-metals. Okay. So easily acquires the energy from the exchange factor, then the electrons moves from the valence band to conduction band through the energy gap. And we should maintain the energy gap value should be less than 3 electron volt. But in insulators, the energy gap plays an important role. Most of the electrons stays only in the valence band itself. So this is valence band and this one is conduction band. And in a conduction band, this is energy value, energy in the conduction band, this is energy in the valence band. And here the energy gap is more than 3 electron volt. When the energy gap goes more than 3 electron volt, most of the electron stays only in the valence band itself, so no electron will be in the conduction band. So there is no conductivity, so there is no possibility of the conductivity. But in the metals, the two bands are overlapping both bands. So overlapping of both bands, which makes the conductivity possible. In semiconductors, it is possible only to the energy value that is less than 3 electron volt. Okay, but in insulators, if the energy gap goes more than 3 electron volt, there is no possibility of. So in this case, no possibility of conduction due to high resistance. But metals that offers very low resistance conductivity is possible. Okay, so next we are going to study in detail about the semiconductors. The semiconductors are classified into two types as intrinsic and extrinsic. So that only we are going to see. Next one is intrinsic semiconductors. There are two types of important semiconductors. One is the intrinsic, another one is extrinsic. Okay, the two types only mainly we are going to dealing in this lesson. The first one is intrinsic semiconductors. In the intrinsic semiconductors, let us take the example of group 14 elements. Let us take group 14 elements. For the example, carbon, germanium and silicon. So these group 14 elements have the valence electrons. Have valence electrons. So four. That is four. Okay. And in a 3D, either the carbon or a germanium or a silicon in three-dimensional structure, it have diamond-like structure. It have diamond-like structure that was mentioned in our books. Diamond-like structure. If you observe the structure very carefully, you can notice that in the valence electrons, each of its atom is shared with another one. So it has a tightly bonded. Okay. So in this diamond-like structure, each atoms are shared with the neighborhood atoms, and it is tightly bonded. Moreover, the shared electron forming a covalent bond. The shared electron from its neighborhood that forms covalent bond. It's a very important thing in this covalent bond. And the covalent bond is also called valence bond. The covalent bond is also called valence bond. Moreover, no bonds are broken at low temperature. So at low temperature in this group 14 elements, the bonds are very strong. The bonds are very strong. And no bonds are broken. That's why we mentioned the bonds are very strong. If temperature is raised, what will happen from 0 Kelvin to room temperature? When a temperature is raised, the bonds become looser and the electron, by thermal energy, by raising the temperatures, the bonds, it breaks the electron bond. And what will happen? The crystal lattice create a vacancy. That is important thing. From 0 Kelvin to room temperature, when a temperature is raised, the bond is loosened due to the thermal energy. So the electron bond breaks and that creates vacancies. So it creates a vacancy. So the vacancies are also called as holes. We are going to deal in the coming topic. The vacancies are also called as holes. Mainly it is positive charge. Okay. The vacancies are mainly positive charge. So in that case, the number of free electron which is equal to number of free electron which is equal to number of holes plus number of holes, that is also equal to the number of intrinsic concentrations, that is also equal to the intrinsic carrier concentration. Intrinsic carrier concentration. That only they mention the number of free electron which is equal to number of holes which is also equal to number of intrinsic carrier concentrations. Okay. I repeat once again from the beginning. There are two important main types of semiconductors. One is intrinsic, another one is extrinsic. In an intrinsic, let us take the example of group 14 elements. The group 14 elements are carbon, germanium and silicon. So these have a valence electron 4. Okay. So the valence electron is 4. That is 2, 8 and remaining 4. The valence electrons only involves mostly the electron sharing. But in the, there are two structures are given. One is in the three-dimensional structures. In the three-dimensional structures, it looks like a diamond shape, a diamond-like structures. Okay, and in this case, the shared electron forms a covalent bond. That is very, very important thing. The covalent means the very strongest bond. This is at low temperature. Suppose to a crystal or to the germanium or silicon or a carbon, if temperature is raised from the room zero Kelvin to room temperature, the bonds are loosened due to the thermal energy. So the electrons become weaker and it creates a vacancy that is also called holes. So the vacancies are mostly positive charge. So in such cases, the number of free electrons in the crystal lattice, which is equal to number of holes, but is also equal to number of intrinsic carrier concentration. Okay. Next, we are going to see in germanium or silicon how it looks. Okay. So now in the previous one, we have seen the three-dimensional structure of group 14 element, that is in intrinsic semiconductors. The example, carbon, germanium or silicon. Now the two-dimensional structure is given, that is for germanium and silicon at very low temperature. So the structure is magnified here, it keeps on goes. In the structures, in a circle we have mentioned plus 4, no. So this indicates germanium or silicon. Okay, it has a 4 valence electron, no, yes. So this is germanium or silicon. And this one, so plus 4 in a circle, that means germanium or silicon, and the dotted one, curve like. So this means a covalent bond. And this shaded one, the circle, shaded circle, that indicates electron. Okay. So at very low temperatures, the electrons are very strong because the covalent bond is a very strong bond. So it is very strong in the structures. Suppose if temperature is raised, what will happen? That is from the lowest temperature to room temperature, there may be a possibility of holes. Let us consider here, there are two sides. This is side 1 and this is side 2. So just for an example, so in this side, initially by raising the temperature, there is a hole created. The holes are nothing but vacancies. Okay. At the time, what will happen? The electrons in the side 2, that replaces and that moves from the side 2 to side 1. Okay. Again, it repeats from the side, now the electron, and here the electron skips from the side 2 to side 1. So here holes are created because the electron that jumps from this side to this side. So here now it become electron and this is the holes. So holes, the empty circle, small circle that represents holes. So this is at room temperature. So first we have seen at lowest temperature, now at room temperature. Imagine, once again I repeat, initially at side 1 there is a hole due to raising the temperature and there is an electron already in the side 2. What will happen? The electron that will jump from the side 2 to side 1, now the hole is replaced by an electron, but this has become an electron now. And this electron goes to the side now, so here it become a hole. Again, it will rearrange from the side 1 to side 2, the electron will jump. So once again, it repeats. So at equilibrium, the number of charge carriers are equal. So in this, due to the movement of an electron and to the hole, there is a possibility of the current. Okay, so the electron and the hole current, the net current in this structure, which is equal to the sum of the net currents in this crystal lattice, which is equal to the sum of electron current and the sum of hole current. This is at equilibrium conditions. Okay, I repeat once again, this is a group 4 14 element. So in this, it has 4 valence electrons. It may be a germanium and silicon. At low temperature, in every bonds, covalent bonds, only the electrons are there. If you raise the temperature, there may be some holes. So if holes in anywhere, the any electrons from any one side that will replace by the holes. And once again, the hole moves. So here, not only the electron moves, also the hole moves. So the number of electrons and the hole pairs, that makes a current due to the mobility. So the moving charge is called current, no? So the net current, which is equal to the sum of electron current and hole current, this is under the equilibrium conditions. The same thing in an energy band, how it looks. Listen. In an energy band, mostly the electrons are intact with the valence band itself. Okay, there are two bands. One is valence band and another one is conduction band. This is a conduction band. So conduction band energy value is EB, EC, conduction band. And this is a valence band. So the energy value is EV, that is energy in the valence band. So the electrons that resides in the valence band itself at 0 Kelvin. Okay, at 0 Kelvin, the electron resides only in the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and 14. So electrons occupies only in the valence band. There is no electrons in the conduction band. It is almost empty. Okay, at 0 Kelvin. Whereas when the temperature is raised, what will happen? If the temperature is raised from 0 Kelvin, that is very lowest temperature, to room temperature, there may be a possibility of electron movement. See, same like structure. And this is energy gap. Okay, this is energy gap and the ground state. See, this is called a valence band and this one is conduction band. So at room temperature, what happens? There are possibility of hole productions. Initially, the electrons are the 14 electrons. Electrons are here. But now what happens? There is a change in the electrons. Okay. So when a thermal energy is given, the bonds are broken and the electrons are loosened, and easily the electrons skip from their valence band to conduction band. How many electrons? 4 electrons. So here, the 4 electrons that moves, that is from, that jumps from the valence band to conduction band. So the electrons reach the conduction band now. So here the corresponding holes are produced. So here produce only the holes. Okay. So how many number of electrons are transferred, that much holes are produced. So that only we have seen. At equilibrium, the number of hole productions, that is also equal to number of electron productions. Therefore, the total current in this case is equal to the sum of electron current and hole currents. Okay, notice that the 4 electrons from the valence band, that is from valence energy level, that is skipped to the conduction band. So the electrons now in the conduction band, whereas their holes alone created. Okay, so the most of the charge carriers in this case are holes and electrons. So the charge of holes, that is nothing but vacancies, that is plus, and for an electron it is minus. Next we are going to see about the extrinsic semiconductors. Now look at the example. This is from the book example, first example. We know already group 14 elements. Carbon, silicon, germanium, these have the same lattice structures, but why carbon is an insulator whereas germanium and silicon are semiconductors? The reasons, we know the carbon, silicon, germanium, these are all occupies the second, third and fourth orbit, okay, respectively. Moreover, the ionization energy is very, very less. You know, ionization energy, easily we can remove the electrons from the excess orbit. So, since the ionization energy is less for, ionization energy is very less for germanium and silicon also, but it is comparatively large for the carbon, but it is large for carbon, okay. This is one reason, and another one reason is the number of free electrons for conduction in germanium and silicon are significant. In this two, germanium and silicon, the number of free electrons are significant. Okay, but in the carbon, it is negligibly small. Okay. But in the carbon, the number of free electrons are negligibly small. So the carbon is a conductor, carbon is a insulator, and germanium and silicon are the semiconductors. Free electrons are negligibly less. Okay, this is the reason. So even though the germanium, carbon, silicon, germanium, these three are belongs to group 14 elements, that is they have the same lattice structure, diamond like structures, but carbon we are considered as an insulator, but the germanium and silicon alone comes under semiconductor. The reasons, it occupies the second and third, fourth orbit, so the ionization energy is very less for the germanium followed by the silicon, so the number of free electrons available is more, but in a carbon the ionization energy is less, okay. Ionization energy is very less. We have to supply more amount of energy to carbon atom to remove an electron. So the ionization energy is more for the carbon, and the ionization energy is less for germanium and silicon, since the carbon has a very less number of free electrons. Okay, relatively small. So the carbon is an insulator. Germanium and the silicon are the semiconductors. The next topic is extrinsic semiconductors.